This is Roosevelt with AutoNetwork. We're here in Plano, Texas at Toyota Headquarters, and we're going to have a quick conversation and demonstration of the May Mobility Autonomous System. And here we have
Laurie Remias. I'm the Director of Marketing at May.
Okay, Laurie, tell me a little bit about the system and how it's supposed to.
Yes, well, it does. So this is our Toyota Sienna Autonomous. As a company, May Mobility has been around since 2017. We have publicly launched autonomous vehicle services in 9 deployments in both the United States and Japan. We've given over 315,000 autonomy-enabled passenger rides. And we've done it on different platforms in the past, but the Toyota Sienna Autonomous is our kind of next-generation platform. So the vehicle we have here today, the vehicle's name is Maki. We name all of our vehicles. They start with the letter M. So Maki is a Sienna Autonomous that will actually be going to Japan in the next couple of months as part of a public deployment that we'll be doing there more than likely next year.
So where are the cameras and the sensors located on this particular?
Yeah, so our cameras and sensors, so we've got a large LiDAR at the top. Then there's different LiDARs on the sides of the vehicles, in the front and in the back.
Let's move around.
Yeah, absolutely. So Carlos, I don't know if you want to describe a little bit about all of the sensors and LiDAR. I think Carlos is our field autonomy engineer and can give kind of an overview of the equipment that's in the vehicle.
Absolutely.
Drafted. Go ahead.
Thank you. Absolutely. So we have on top our LiDAR, which is a VLS-128. In total, we have 7 cameras. Below the LiDAR, you can see 3 of them, one pointing straight up, and there's a 45-degree angle of separation between the others. The other 4, as you can see below, there's one here, one in the back, and 3 on the sides. In addition to that, we have radars on every corner of the vehicle, as you can see on those areas below. And not only do we have that Velodyne over there, but we have also here, and if you walk around this side, you can see this other LiDAR here. And one of the reasons why we have so many sensors is so that we can have a good understanding of our environment, and we can compose a pretty thorough view of 360 of our surroundings and compose a detailed image that highlights the benefits of every sensor. Whereas cameras provide a lot of semantic information, radars can tell you the velocity and the speed of all the objects around you. And our Velodyne on top can give us quite the resolution of the environment around us.
And what's the distance of the cameras?
So the cameras don't have a distance per se. The Velodyne itself has around 90 to 100 meters of field of view, and this is just given at the velocity that we are spinning. And we are.
Let's take a little bit, take a quick look at the rear.
Absolutely. These 2 objects over here are also radars. A camera and a LiDAR.
And these will, this system will go in production when?
So this is already this particular vehicle has not been deployed. It will be deployed later on this year in Japan. However, May Mobility is already operating in different cities in the U.S. and our services are deployed in Fishers, Indiana, Arlington, Texas, and Ann Arbor, Michigan.
And those that are deployed already are just test vehicles?
No, they are open to public and anybody can hop in one of our shuttles and drive around. For example, in Fishers, Indiana, as long as you see one available shuttle, you can get in at no cost. Whereas in Ann Arbor and Arlington, you can download an app, a May Mobility app, and as long as you're within the service area, you can order a ride and it'll take you to your destination.
Are they on fixed highways or they can go
no,
the streets?
No, they are in urban environments. So those are not highway operating.
No, I
right
mean,
now.
Yeah, when I say highway, I mean regular streets.
Oh, yes, regular streets.
So you can go anywhere in the city of Arlington.
No. It's not anywhere in the city of Arlington.
It's a restricted area.
Yes, it is a geo-fenced area.
Okay.
And as long as you're within that area, you can be provided a service.
Okay, great. Thanks very much.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.